The Greek Bible, their Bible of the Ionians and of all the Greeks, was Homer. It was the heroic warrior poetry of the Iliad and the Odyssey that every Greek was raised on, to where if you look in Heraclitus, there are many of his most famous fragments that are almost in a Homeric-sounding meter. Ho anax hu tomandeion estito en delpois utelege utecrute alla semaine. So, this mean in English, the Lord whose oracle is in Delphi does not speak nor hides, but gives a sign. But in, I read you the Greek, I hope you don't think it's too pretentious of me to do so, but you hear a kind of rhythm, and it's roughly the same rhythm as in Homer poetry. It's called dactylic hexameter, it doesn't matter, but it's a rhythm of the line, like iambic pentameter. But this poetry and this vision of life entered the mind of every Greek. And even though actually Heraclitus' other fragments attacking Homer, where he say Homer should be whipped, but this Homeric spirit and even way of expression, it exists in Heraclitus. You hear it in sayings. He practiced a kind of oracular vision into the nature of things. The art of the mantic, you could say. The oracle or the prophet. And like all true oracles, the signature of this is terseness, an extreme clarity that to the uninitiated it looks like obscurity or something enigmatic, but is not. That much of it existed in these kinds of terse sentences, these oracular sentences, where reality emerges in the struggle of opposites, where all things are birthed by the tension between natural forces that are struggling to grab matter from each other to express themselves in time and space. All reality in Heraclitian vision becomes entirely action, and things are seen to exist only as a result of their action upon other things. Or in other words, all material reality is nothing but pure causality, pure action, or what in German would be called Wirklichkeit.